proud elegance and a graceful, powerful physique. The supreme Marwari horses have been worshipped in India for thousands of years as magic, divine creatures.
Our gods created the horses. Once, when they were making sacrifices at a fire, one of them cried. A tear from the right eye changed into a stallion. A mare flowed from the left eye. Since then, the people of Rajasthan have believed that horses are gods.
Every year in November, the small, barren desert oasis of Pushkar becomes a place of pilgrimage for millions of Indians. The Pushkar Mela, Rajasthan's trading place for over 50,000 camels and horses, transforms the place into the bazaar of the year. For 9 days, each tries in their own way to get their hands on some money. The Mela is good for business. Rajasthan's most beautiful horses are on sale here. To ride through the Pushkar Mela on one of the legendary Marwari horses just once, that has been Sunaram's greatest dream. The 14-year-old works as a stable boy. He wants to spend his whole life with horses.
When I am big, I want to be a really good horse rider. Today, I wanted my horse to run fast, so that everyone would think, wow, he can ride really well. But it just didn't happen. The horse simply didn't want to race, whatever I tried.
Late last night, Sunaram arrived here from southern Rajasthan. Teaching him the secrets of horse grooming is the old horse master, Hiralal.
Lift the bucket up high, close to the mare's head, then she'll drink. The mare wants hay, she's hungry, she doesn't want water. When she lifts her hoof, she needs hay. You must learn to understand the language of horses. Try to make the horse happy. The horse will only run well for you if it's happy.
I've always loved horses. I just want to be near them. Hiralal is showing me everything I need to know. I've already learned so much from him.
Marwari horses can only be found in the north of India. The horses are considered exceptionally loyal, courageous, and with a strong character. In Pushkar, everybody who's anybody in Rajasthan's world of horses is gathering. Maharajas, breeders, and horse masters. Breeders Ajit Singh and Raghuvendra Singh have dedicated their lives to Marwari horses. The two Rajputs are looking for particularly valuable animals in Pushkar. They have their price. You pay up to 70,000 euros for a Marwari.
These ears are perfectly formed. Oh, yes, they are. Like two parrots flirting with each other. Looks very in love.
Marwari horses were mentioned in the old Vedic scriptures. The wiry Marwaris are considered extremely good desert horses. They are known for their hardiness and stamina, even in extreme temperatures. The pointed, movable, sickle-shaped ears are the hallmark of the Marwaris.
Also typical is the ram-like nose, which curls outwards. Arab horses' noses curl inwards, while Marwari's noses curl outwards. This one here is perfect. This swirl is really important and characteristic. It has to be exactly at eye level, not underneath it, like this one.
Owning a perfect Marwari is the pride and joy of Indian breeders. But it only brings good luck when it has five divine signs. Ajit is looking for one such special horse.
I heard that you had a special foal to sell. Yes, it's at home at the stables. It has a white face, white legs, and his ears are big and have a nice shape. Its mother is tall. Can we do business? Guaranteed, mother and foal are very good.
Ajit knows he can trust this dealer. His father used to buy horses from him too.
I remember he always used to say, you can tell the character of a horse by looking at its mane. If it is thin and the hairs fall out easily, that means it's nervous and short-tempered.
Horse master Hiralal's family has been working for Ajit's stud farm for generations. Since the breeder has to stay in Pushkar on business, he sends his horse master on the road.
Take me with you.
What for?
I want to be there.
It will be tiring.
I won't be tired.
Okay, you can come.
The dance shows are one of the highlights of the Pushkar horse market. Traditionally, many Marwaris were not trained for riding, but for dancing at celebrations. Jury chairman Maharaja Bonny knows the war-related roots of the horse dance.
Marwaris used to be deployed in the cavalry and trained for battle. How were they supposed to overpower their opponents who were on elephants? They could only succeed if they stood upright on two legs so that the king could chop off the enemy's head.
The horses can stay on their back legs for several minutes, even though it's extremely tiring for them. Pushkar Lake. People say the god Brahma dropped a lotus flower right here in the desert sand, and that the lake water sprang from its blossoms. Sunaram and Hiralal leave the sacred site.
I prayed that we would find an extraordinary horse. If the gods are with us, there will be no problems.
Both have a long and difficult journey ahead of them. The foal is in a little farm in the desert Thar, a good 100 kilometers away. They will be on the road for 2 to 3 days.
Is this bus going to Jodhpur?
Yes, hop in.
The old man has been a friend to Sunaram for years. His own father is dead, and his mother left him years ago.
I can barely remember my parents. They left me when I was still very young. I often feel quite alone.
After a four-hour journey, they reach the small town of Jodhpur. On the way, the horse master tells the old Marwari legends, like the one where the sun god lost his seven horses. God Brahma comforted him with a seven-headed stallion for his chariot. The sun god rode across the heavens in a sparkling chariot until he fell to earth.
The sun god's chariot landed in front of seven virgins with their eyes blindfolded. Each of them was allowed to remove the blindfold for a moment to take a glance at the stallion. They fell pregnant, and that's how the first seven horses on earth came to life.
Both have been on the road the whole day when the journey comes to a halt in a little village. They've missed the bus.
Whatever happens, we must find this horse. We will buy a good horse.
Time is running out. They have to get to the desert in the morning before the scorching midday sun. Sunaram is slowly losing interest. All that trouble just for a foal? But they're not looking for any old horse. They're looking for a Panch Kalyan, a five times luck.
It has five signs, a white spot on its head and four white legs. The horse with these markings brings five times as much luck. Panch Kalyan.
Hiralal and Sunaram approach the desert. They have to change the vehicle once more. The streets end here, and the transport becomes more and more basic.
Pretty dry. Here too. Even drier over there. Completely dried out.
I told you it was too dry here.
Nothing but arid desert, far and wide.
7 hours later, they finally reach the horse breeder's stables. Sunaram spots the foal immediately.
What a beautiful color. It is truly a sacred horse, a Panch Kalyan. See how soft the coat is. It feels really good, really nice. It is still so young and so good. We absolutely have to have it. I like it a lot.
Horsemaster Hiralal is immediately convinced that the journey was worth it, that this horse is a good choice.
It's a Panch Kalyan.
For a sacred horse, it has the nicest color. This rich brown brings even more good luck.
The foal is just 3 months old. The seller only wants to sell it together with the mother mare.
How old is she?
3.5.
She's certainly older than three.
What exactly are you looking for?
I have to check everything, especially the swirl on her coat. There are some that bring bad luck. Are those lentil leaves? Do you feed the horses with them?
Yes.
What else do you give them?
Broomcorn millet.
And green lentils too?
Yeah, sure.
Hiralal knows his breeder Ajit likes horses with a strong, spirited character. But he's not actually supposed to buy a mare. But it's impossible to refuse the elegant foal. The dealer has an easy game.
I can't possibly separate the foal from the mother. It's simply too young.
It's not that young anymore.
I'll only sell the two together.
Give me a good price. I would take both horses too.
You only buy good horses from me. 500,000.
I'll give you 400,000.
Never. Okay, you've come a long way. Let's close the deal at 460,000.
Let's do that.
Hiralal pays 20 rupees. With this symbolic sum, a deal in India is considered perfect. The rest comes later. A tussock, a tuft of grass, is handed over to seal the deal. With this gesture, the previous owner wishes the horse good sustenance with a new owner.
The horses will be well looked after by us, I promise.
The horses have been bred as robust desert horses in the former kingdom of Marwar since the 12th century. Marwaris are intelligent and have stamina, but they're also modest enough for the tough conditions of the desert Thar. With their extremely hard hooves, they can also move easily in the deep sand. Their silky coats keep the horses cool in the hot summer months and warm them in the cold desert nights. Stable boy Sunaram has already become very fond of the foal.
I would like to decide on the name now. Maybe Sidraj, Albila, or Hansaraj? Raja would be the best.
Raja.
There are countless myths and legends surrounding Rajasthan's former rulers and their horses.
Once, when the sun god was riding through the heavens in his chariot, he came across a group of jealous gods. Consumed by jealousy, they cut off the horse's wings.
Cut off?
Yes, just cut them off. The blood dropped to earth. The Rajputs were created from the blood of these horses, from every single drop of blood. There's so much to know about horses. You still have a lot to learn.
Dundlod, in the northern Shekhawati Desert. The small hamlet still oozes the charms of times gone by, when the Rajputs still had power and riches. A thriving horse cult, which the old walls still chronicle, celebrates horses as sacred creatures. Blessed by the gods and worshipped by the people, the Marwaris became a symbol of power and strength of the aristocratic warrior caste. Rajaboni belongs to the old Shikar dynasty, the former rulers of the region. He has the largest stud farm for the sensitive Marwari horses in Rajasthan.
No other animal is as sensitive. Whether you're angry, sad, or scared, a horse can sense it and responds to it.
Breeder Ajit Singh and Bonnie haven't seen each other since the horse market in Pushkar. Ajit wants to look at the new horses in Bonnie's stables.
This mare is getting a foal. It will be a baby of Gajraj. No one wanted this horse. Hindus believe that the color black brings bad luck. I was looking for a mare like this, but she was sold from one owner to the next. I finally found her at the fourth owner.
In old times, Marwaris were bred by Rajasthan's kings and treasured as robust war horses. Marwaris can more or less gallop from a stance with their inexhaustible energy reserves. Their alert and perceptive intelligence allows a heightened communication between horse and rider.
Our relationship has become closer and closer from generation to generation. I have never experienced this understanding with any other horse, only with Marwaris.
Bonnie is a pioneer of Marwari breeding, with only one goal. He wants to revive the Marwari tradition to its former prime. The old horse culture was almost completely destroyed under British rule.
The British understood the major mythological significance of the horses for the Indian aristocracy. They thought, if we replace Marwaris with our horses, that will strengthen our power in India. That's why they castrated thousands of Marwari horses in the 20s.
The breeder took on the cause of Rajasthan's noble horses with all his heart in the mid-1980s. The next morning, Hiralal and Sonaram lead the two horses onto a truck, which will take them directly to the stud farm in Naralai. Breeder Ajit can hardly wait to see his two new arrivals.
Hey, Hiralal, did everything go okay?
Yes, fine.
How's the mare?
She's very good.
The ears are perfect. And she has good swirl on her forehead.
She's almost 5 years old.
Good. How is the foal?
Nice. Let me see. Good swirl. Very, very nice.
Two good new horses. A real family event on the small stud farm. Ajit calls his mother and two sisters to come. The priest from the village temple has come to bless the two new arrivals. The Hindu ritual of the Brahman is supposed to protect the horses. Before leading them into the stables for the first time, the two horses are covered in orangey-red covers, the same color as the Rajputs' war turbans. It is a sign of the deep affinity between horses and the Maharajas. They say that Marwaris can only bring luck in a household of the warrior caste.
For us, horses are the sons of the sun. We believe they are the reincarnation of Vishnu, the son of the sun god Surya. When we lead the horses into the house, it's as if we were inviting God Vishnu.
Panch Kalyan, five times luck, is moving into Ajit's stables today. A good omen for the future. The next morning, the mare appears to be exhausted. The horse master prepares a revitalizing Ayurveda medicine, onions, garlic, salt, ginger, chili, and a handful of Indian spices are ground and formed into a solid ball.
And that will make her fit again?
Exactly. But you have to grind it very well.
Hiralal prepares the herbal medicine for the horses based on one of his grandfather's old recipes.
Does she have to swallow the whole ball?
Yes, she has to eat everything.
He begins with an Ayurveda massage in order to balance the mare's energy reserves again. According to the old Vedic scriptures, every part of the horse's body represents part of the universe. His stomach is the atmosphere. His back is the sky. His bones represent the constellations. Since the very beginning, the Maharajas have tamed horses based on the idea that they are subjugating the cosmos. The secrets of natural healing methods have been passed on from the horse master to the stable boys for generations now. Sonaram is now also responsible for the health of the foal Raja.
I will always look after the foal and bring it up. I want us to be together my whole life.
In the afternoon, Ajit tries out the new mare. It is not just its appearance that determines the quality of the horse. Character is also very important. The breeder knows how to read the language of horses.
When you're galloping through sand and the horse is getting slower and slower, it's telling you that it wants to roll around in the sand. Sometimes a horse turns its head from right to left, although there is no lake. That means it's thirsty.
Ajit is satisfied. This mare has everything a good Marwari horse needs.
When I see Ajit riding, I wish I was grown up already and could do that too.
For Diwali, the Indian festival of lights, all the houses are adorned in color and decorated so as to win the god's favor. Sunaram visits his grandmother's house, a call of duty. He feels alien here. He moved out when he became a stable boy. He would rather celebrate the festival of lights in the stables with the horses. When his father died, Sunaram's mother had to leave the family. As is normal in India, she wasn't allowed to take her son with her into the new marriage. At the same time, Ajit also lost his father. For Sunaram, this turned out to be a happy twist of fate.
When Sunaram's father died, his mother came to us and said, I don't know what to do with him. Please look after my child. Then I thought, whatever will become of him? He doesn't have anyone anymore. Fate brought us together. More and more, he has become part of our family. We are sort of like his guardian angels.
During the Festival of Lights, Sunaram and Ajit remember their fathers together. Hindus believe that on the new moon of the Diwali, the souls of their ancestors visit the house. Candles are lit to show them the way. The candles are also a symbol of luck, wealth, and progress. Lakshmi, the goddess of wealth, only enters brightly lit houses. In order to honor his horses and to ask for riches, Ajit blesses his horses.
वर्तमान से भविष्य की ओर ऊंचाइयों की ओर वो बुलंदियों की ओर चलता है.
Horses mean a good future for me. That's why I honor them at Diwali.
इसलिए मैं घोड़ों को हमेशा दिवाली में दिवाली साथ मनाना चाहता हूँ.
Every morning, all the horses are let out of the stables. Like wild horses, they spend the whole day completely free to run around on the meadows around the stud farm. They live according to a natural hierarchy. It is not easy for the full Raja to find his place. He wasn't born in the stable, and his mother is a stranger in the herd too.
What will happen in the future if you stay so attached to the horse?
We have to look after it.
What you have to do is feed it. If you feed it well, it will grow big and strong. What's the point of getting attached to it?
I have to love it, because it is still so small.
I love it, but let it graze as well.
A difficult moment. Breeder Ajit lives from his horse business. He is organizing a wedding in the neighboring village. The stable boy is the youngest among the men on the farm. This is his first time at such an important ceremony.
You have to wind it round exactly.
Yeah, really hard work.
I only go around a few times.
On occasions like these, all the men wear the same headdress. The full Raja will be used for the first time today. Sunaram wants to do everything right.
Today, the foal is appearing in public at the wedding. That's why I'm decorating it. I want everyone to see how beautiful it is.
Horses are the central figures in marriages in Rajasthan. A white horse bringing good luck is supposed to carry the bridegroom to his fiancée. November is the traditional Indian wedding month. People marry when there's a full moon because the stars are a sign that the future will be good. Marwari horses dance instinctively as soon as the music begins. They move as if the steps were programmed in their genes. Yet the foal is getting anxious. All the people and the noise are making Raja nervous. The procession reaches its climax. The bride's house is symbolized by an archway. The bridegroom touches an ornament over the door with a sword to signal his entrance. In former times, the men often had to ride far to reach the bride's house. They were often attacked on the way. Sometimes the bridegroom didn't survive the journey. Then the bride married the sword. To everyone's surprise, a breeder has been in touch with Ajit and is offering a lot of money for a panch kalyan, a sacred foal. Ajit can hardly say no.
Tomorrow morning we'll set off. We'll see if we can sell it.
Breeder's farm is a day's journey away. A panch kalyan brings his owner five times as much luck, so they say. So Ajit is hoping for a tidy sum of money from the sale of the much sought after foal.
Thank you.
The full Raja is especially valuable because of his snow-white forehead. Sunaram has an idea.
Today, people are mad about Panch Kalyan. If there was dark hair on the forehead, either on the foal or the mare, the deal would be off.
They go at a mere walking pace because of the foal. Also, due to the heat. They don't reach the breeder stables until late evening. The farm is known for its extraordinary breeding success. Idealistic and passionate about Marwaris, breeder Hemant Deval only buys the best stud horses in Rajasthan. Impressed by the large property, the next morning, Sunaram explores the stables. It is his dream to own valuable horses like these himself one day.
Such beautiful stables. They take good care of their horses and give them plenty to eat. But I still don't want the foal to stay here. It is the most important thing for me.
Yet the horses have to be prepared for the sale. A lot of money is involved now. There's no place for feelings here.
We'll get them really clean. I'll do the mare first, you wash the foal. It has to be really clean. Sunaram, now you. Make your horse really clean. Perfect.
You're giving it away? You want to sell my foal?
Sunaram has an idea. Maybe he can still prevent the sale.
Ready.
Hemant Deval only accepts the very best Marwaris into his stables.
That would be a foal for my farm. I think I'll take the Panch Kalyan. What's that on his forehead? Where? Why does it have dark hairs? That must have been the boy. You're always getting up to mischief. What have you done?
The misunderstanding is cleared up quickly. Ajit gets 350,000 rupees for Raja. But he'll only sell on one condition. He wants to shine in public with the foal once more and show it off at the Dundlad Horse Festival. Hidalal and Sunaram set off to the fort of Dundlad, where they are hoping the horses will win prizes. Sunaram knows he has gone too far. He has never seen Ajit so angry before. Now he's scared he'll lose everything. In Dundlad, the celebrations for the Gangaur festival are already in full swing. For two full days, the Rajasthanis honor their gods. Hundreds of years ago, the Rajas attacked their enemies on horseback. At full gallop, they ripped their opponents' tent pegs out of the ground. Caught under the collapsed tents, the enemy was easy prey. This old tradition lives on today in horse competitions. They say that Marwaris have a natural talent for fighting. Their fearlessness, passion, and the desire to conquer made Marwari stallions very coveted warhorses. Hundreds of years, the horses have been honored at the Gangaur festival. Rajasthan's breeders show off their stallions, silky coats, heads held up high. The Rajput warhorse is said to possess a proud beauty, looking over the world with watchful, intelligent eyes. Ajit is looking for precisely these qualities for the prize of best stallion in Shikawati. Once the men have shown what they have to offer, the women appear. They flock in their hundreds to Dundlod's fort. The Gangaur festival honors the day of the holy marriage between the goddess Parvati and the god Shiva. On this day, the married women pray for a fulfilling marriage. The young girls wish for a loving husband. Sunaram's wishes also concern the future. He would like to win the competition for the most beautiful foal, but doesn't know how to make his dream come true.
Sunaram, why are you pulling a face like that?
Ajit is still angry with me because I painted the foal's head black. I want to make it up to him.
If the foal wins, he will be happy, and then everything will be okay.
Like so often before, the experienced horse master Hiralal has an idea of how he can help the stable boy. In the competitions, you can see the Rajasthani's deep reverence for the animals that have served them for thousands of years in the desert. Lavishly decorated and made to dance, the pack animals seem like mythical creatures from a past era. Sunaram and his master are getting ready.
You go ahead. I'll come right after you.
You can see the potential of a horse when it is still quite young. The tension in the body and an upright posture tell you a lot about his determination. An alert curiosity shows that it is fearless. That was precisely Hiralal's plan. He keeps the mare and himself close to the foal Raja. As soon as she senses her foal, she begins to whinny. Raja cranes his neck, looks alert and interested. Now, the jury has to be convinced.
How old is it?
3 months old.
Sunaram wins. A victory at the horse festival in Dundlod can hardly be matched with gold. Ajit has Sunaram to thank for this victory. The breeder knows this. He is extremely satisfied.
Very good, very good, very good, very good.
Well done. Bravo. Here's a sweet reward. Half for you, the other for Raja. Don't worry anymore. You're special to me. Sonaram is very clever, learns quickly and has a friendly way about him. Now we just have to get him on the right track. I am sure one day he will know all there is to know about horses.
This day could have hardly had a better end. Sonaram enjoys his success.
I am so pleased that the foal won the competition and that Ajit is no longer mad. Now I live there, ride and learn everything about horses, and someday I'll work on the race course.
Sonaram has proven that he is serious about it. He wants to learn to understand horses. The work in Ajit's stables will open many doors for him. Doors which will allow him to spend his whole life with Marwaris. This has always been his dream.